Good morning, Purnell Penguins. Welcome back from the weekend. You're watching the KPHE Penguin News now. My name is Alex, and I'll be your first host today. This is Monday, May 1st, 2023. It is our 145th day of school. We now have 35 days left to go in our school year after today. Our number of the day is 145. Can you think of an equation that equals 145? Here's one I thought of. 29 times 5 equals 145. The weather for today looks to be mostly cloudy with a high of 59 degrees. On this day in history, in 1931, the Empire State Building opened in New York City at 102 stories. It was the world's tallest building for the next 41 years. Have a great Monday. Aubrey will take it from here.
Hi, my name is Aubrey. I'm your second host for today. Here's a random fun fact of the day. The Statue of Liberty was originally supposed to be located in Suez Canal. Weird but true. Did you know that today is May Day? Looking back at past decades, May has had different meanings of diverse countries and cultures. Today in the United States, as our countries, it is a celebration of the season of spring. May Day is a public holiday celebrated on May 1st. In many different cultures around the world, it is a day of unity, togetherness, and rebirth. A day for everyone to come together and celebrate life as we know it. We'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Tyler in room 21, Quentin in room 6, Edwin in room 10, and Hazel in room 4. Happy birthday! Sorry if I pronounced any of your names wrong. Next, we'll hand things over to Ms. Swan, and then Tyler will take it over from there.
Hi, Prune Hill Penguins. Hope you had a nice weekend. Wasn't the weather crazy last week? Sunny and warm like summertime. I noticed a lot of friends had their shorts on and short sleeves and tank tops, and the wind was blowing like it does in the summertime. It was really, really nice. Makes us look forward to summer. But it's not summer yet. It's still springtime. Which means summer, if you know, the first day of summer is in June. Do you know what day in June that is? Think about that one a little bit. But we're still in the spring season where flowers are growing and birds. Wow, the birds are chirping really loud really early in the morning. I know some teachers are really early risers and are outside on their property taking care of their animals and just enjoying slow mornings. And I know they've noticed the birds really loud early in the morning. It is the month of May already, but we still have about 7 or 8 weeks left of school. You probably know better than I do how many days, because a lot of you have a countdown on in your math number corner, so you know what day of school it is, plus the news crew tells us that, and how many days are left of school. We have lots of exciting things coming up this week, since it's the beginning of May. I want you to count, if today's May 1st, see if you can figure out why I'm playing this song. What is this song from? What is that? What movie is that? And why am I playing that the first week of May? I'll give you a hint. It has to do with Thursday. So look at a calendar and figure out what Thursday is and what the connection is. And I wonder if on Thursday, if you have a Star Wars t-shirt or Star Wars anything, you could wear that on Thursday. But why would you wear it on Thursday? Maybe you can come and find me at lunchtime and tell me why you might be wearing that shirt on Thursday. Anyhow, on Wednesday evening, our first grade friends are having an open house where you get to come in and show your family and your grown-up what it is you're learning and what you've learned so far, and see each other's timelines. That's always a fun tradition. And if you are a fourth or fifth grade choir, recorder choir, vocal choir, you also this week have a performance in the evening. So that's coming up. So that'll be exciting in the gym. So those are our first two big events happening this week. And then more are coming, more field trips, more celebrations, and more open houses. So make it a good week. Work hard, be kind, work hard during while you're inside working so you can play hard when you're outside. And remember that we're looking for your best effort, that you're trying, not that you get it right, but that you're trying. All right, have a great week. See you soon.
Hi, my name is Tyler, and I'm one of your hosts for today. It's time now for a book talk. One of my favorite books is called The Underdogs. This book is about a town, and it had this factory. The factory sold shoes that were very famous and made the town a lot of money. But one day, the factory shuts down because brands like Nike, New Balance, Under Armour were more popular than the factory that made the shoes. So that shut down, and the town lost a lot of money. This boy, Will, really loves football, and they might not have a football season just because the factory shut down and they might not have enough money. But Will has to try to find a way to get the season back and gather up a bunch of money. But even if he does, many of the kids who were on his team in the past years moved away because their parents got different jobs in different places. So even if he does get the money, he has to find players to make a team, and he wants to get to the championship game because after this season, they might not have another season. I really like this book, and I would recommend it. It's time for announcements about what's happening around the school. Vocal choir will have rehearsal after school today, and recorder choir will have rehearsal after school on Wednesday. Then on Thursday evening, they will have a concert at 6 in the gym. Robotics team will meet tomorrow and Thursday after school in room 17. On Wednesday evening, first grade classes will have their open house at 5:30. Now Elise will end our broadcast for the day.
Hello, Penguins. I'm Elise, and I'm your final host for today. Our environment is important to us. What is one small thing you can start doing today to help save the environment? How about this idea? Use reusable shopping bags. Do your parents have bags that they can use over and over every time they go to the grocery store? That could be a great gift idea for their birthday. Please remember to say the Pledge of Allegiance with your class sometime today. Let's all show our Penguin pride by being safe, respectful, responsible, and kind. This is Elise saying goodbye from the Penguin News Studio. Have a marvelous Monday!